Work family does not exist. There is a place for work and a place for family. Your company is not your family. Your coworkers are clearly not your family. You need to stop calling them such. Having a positive work culture doesn't mean that you should think of your coworkers as of a family. If you are in an interview, you ask interviewers about their company culture and they say, "We are like a family," and that there is no office politics here. Now, this is a clear warning sign of a red flag. Many bad companies will lean towards this work family concept to get a cult-like loyalty out of you. Work family is not the same thing as being part of a respectful and a collaborative environment. The coworkers are your family dynamic is often used by both CEOs and managers in hopes of keeping employees loyal. But this kind of dynamic and terminology can often lead to painful career experiences. I'm Marat from EMMOTION, and after years of experience in corporate HR and in executive search, I'd like to share with you three reasons why the work family concept is a lie and why your coworkers are not your family. If you are not subscribed to my channel yet, then definitely hit the subscribe below and enable the notification bell so you won't miss out my weekly professional growth content. Also, tap the like button if you are ready to proceed. Now let's start with the culture that the work family promotes. Framing your coworkers as your family and thinking about your company as a work family has clear advantages for your company, but not really for you. Of course, you spend at least 40 hours a week at your company with your colleagues. It's only human nature wanting to belong. But when you think of your company and your coworkers as of your family, you may bring dysfunction into the workplace, which sooner or later backfires against you. Why? Because you would normally do anything for your family. So naturally, if your work family needs help, you will put the required extra time and effort to help them get through those times, like projects, those late hour meetings, presentations, events, etc. The first and the biggest reason why work isn't family because loyalty doesn't go both ways. Employers that say that employees are family wouldn't hesitate to fire them if it came down to it. While as a family, you support each other through tough times, no matter what. This is never really the case when it comes down to business. Where family type of employers also make it extremely difficult for you to ask for a raise or for a vacation, because you might feel like they've already been doing so much for you. Let me make this very clear. An employer can deny you a pay raise because the business is struggling or because it's a small company. If they can't afford to pay you more, they can say no. But you can't be punished or emotionally blackmailed due to asking for a pay raise. You can't be manipulated into a theory that asking for a raise isn't appropriate because we are a family here. Remember this, work is not a family. Work is a contract. The same kind of manipulation appears when they lean on you to work long hours, when they lean on you to work on weekends, yet you can't ever complain about bad management. Because hey, we are a family. If you complain, then you are not a team player. Does this ring a bell to you? The second reason why this concept is a lie, because the open doors are never really open. This will easily explain itself. Remember how many times you've been in a meeting when your manager or coworker said that you are completely free to speak your mind. In fact, the management claims that you are always welcome to walk into the office and speak to your boss. Because the door is always open, they say. So eventually, one day, you decide to speak your mind. You listen to them and try to be honest while giving your feedback. And what happens? This just doesn't go well. Suddenly you might become an enemy, a traitor, someone who doesn't fit in and who will get psychologically blackmailed for speaking up. And why is that? Because the open doors and we are family are simply a combination of manipulative words. Don't ever get confused. There are so many times I heard, "We are family here," used to silence or to excuse toxic workplace behaviors like bullying or gaslighting. Or you know, he's like that sometimes, but we are all used to it because We're a family here. He just has a bad temper. Wait a minute, what? So workplace abuse should be tolerated and excused because we are a family here? No, let's not mix it up. Tolerating workplace abuse can't be excused. Being belittled or bullied at work can't be excused. This is work, and there should be a healthy and respectful environment. There should always be boundaries set in a workplace and in relationships with your colleagues. Coworkers are not your family because the relationships at work are dependent and opportunistic. And that's because it's business for all of you, and things just work that way. I'd love to hear your thoughts and personal experiences on this. And the next reason why work family is a lie is because leaving or abandoning your family is one of the worst things you can do. And this can't be said, or rather shall not be said, about leaving work. After all, business is business. When outsourcing your work saves the company a lot of money, they will do it. They will even close your department down without any hesitation, because it's business, it's nothing personal. Or when the company isn't doing well and they have to make a decision of getting you laid off. That's business, it's not personal. And how come where family concept is not applied here? But whenever it's yourself wanting to leave the company, that's when you are being sent on a guilt trip. Because they are your family, and you can't abandon your family. Do you see why this is a huge lie? You don't owe your company anything, just like they don't owe you anything. It's business for both. So if you see a better opportunity for yourself, take it. If you've outgrown your position or have a different career vision, then it's only your right to move forward. Of course, it's important to manage your departure gracefully. This shall never be questioned. But feeling guilty is definitely not the way. In conclusion, this we are family mindset companies eventually create a toxic work environment and damaging work dynamics for you. If you think that this is your company's case, check out the video where I discuss some of the signs of a toxic workplace. Thanks for staying with me till the end. If you found this video useful, please give it a thumb up and share it with whoever you think might find it beneficial. Don't forget to hit the subscribe, and see you in my next video coming up.